Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Charisse, and this video is a little different from any of the other ones that I have posted in the past. Let me start by saying I am not a historian, and I am not a history aficionado, if you will, but I did come across an article a while back that really piqued my interest, and I hope that it piques yours as well. It's about the only black African-American family on the Titanic in 1912. I think this story should be told, and this is my little way of sharing some of the information with you. If you're interested in hearing the story about the LaRoche family, please keep watching. So let me begin with Joseph. Joseph Philippe Lemessier LaRoche was born May 26, 1886. Joseph LaRoche was a Paris-educated Haitian engineer. After graduating with an engineering degree, he married a French woman named Juliette Lafargue. When Joseph graduated, he expected to find employment as an engineer. There were opportunities in Paris for someone with his education. However, there was a problem he had not thought of. Although France is a pretty country with beautiful scenery, marvelous cities, and nice people, racial prejudice at that time could prevent someone from employing a young, dark-skinned man. Joseph did find work, but his employers made excuses that he was young and inexperienced and paid him poorly. A year later, the young couple celebrated the birth of their first daughter, Simone, on February 19, 1909. On July 2, 1910, Louise was born. She was premature and frail, suffering from many medical problems in her first years. Joseph had to find a better-paying job to support his children, who were very important to him. In 1911, he decided to return to Haiti, where there surely was a need for qualified young engineers. The country was far from modern. There would be great opportunities, and his family could have a better standard of living. Travel to Haiti was planned for the next year. When she discovered she was pregnant in March 1912, Joseph decided an earlier departure was better. His wife would be less tired, and they preferred the child be born in Haiti. If they didn't leave immediately, departure would be delayed for some time. They wanted to avoid traveling with a newborn on what would already be a tiresome trip. Joseph's mother bought the tickets as a welcome present for the new family. The crossing was booked on CGT's French line's newest steamship, a four-funneled liner France. Her maiden voyage was April 20th, bound for New York from Le Havre. The company's policy at the time required children to stay in the nursery. Children were not allowed in the ship's restaurant, even with their parents. This policy annoyed Juliette and Joseph. He insisted he would not be separated from his two girls, so their tickets were changed, transferring their passage to the White Star's newest steamship, Titanic, also on her maiden voyage from Southampton, with a stop to Cherbourg, to New York, leaving 10 days earlier on April 10th. Louise LaRoche was one of the last remaining survivors of the sinking of the RMS Titanic on April 15th, 1912. The first recollections of April 15, 1912 were of the canard Carpathia, when they were hauled up in bags. Simone remembered how frightening it had been, and the image stayed with her. Earlier, a steward had come to their cabin and told them to wear their life jackets. Titanic had suffered an accident. Joseph put everything valuable, money and jewels, in his pocket. Unable to understand, Juliette let Joseph, who spoke English fluently, lead her to the lifeboats. He put his pregnant wife and their two daughters onto a lifeboat. They survived, but he did not. Juliet and the girls were directed to a hospital where her frozen feet were treated. The loss of her husband, personal belongings, combined with pain and fright, made her cancel continuing to Haiti, instead deciding to return to the familiarity of France. Passage was on the liner Chicago, because she was a French ship. The La Roches were back in Le Havre in May, and then home to her father. In March 1995, Louise La Roche stepped aboard the SS Nomadic for the first time since 1912, when it carried her family to the Titanic from Cherbourg, France. She was joined by fellow Titanic survivor Melvina Dean. That same year, Louise was present as the Titanic Historical Society dedicated a stone marker in Cherbourg commemorating Titanic passengers who sailed from its port. Miss Louise La Roche was an honorary member of the Titanic Historical Society until her death. Louise La Roche died on January 28, 1988, at the age of 87. Joseph La Roche died in the sinking of the Titanic. His body was never recovered. The La Roches enjoyed the opulent amenities of the ship, dining in the same dining room as its first-class passengers. However, they were subjected to stares and some insults from fellow passengers and crew who frowned upon their interracial marriage. After the sinking of the Titanic, the White Star Line extended a public apology for the racism exhibited by its crew members towards its non-white passengers, including La Roche. Thanks for watching.